Seriously, the president.
At this level, there aren't that many people he can trust.
How do I know you're not making all this up?
The things I'm telling you, you don't joke around about. It could be dangerous.
Dangerous?
You know, most people, they get into their warm beds at night. They have no idea what really goes on out there. The sheer number of people working to destroy our way of life. And you know why I've dedicated my life to stopping them?
Why?
Because.
You ready for this?
Something else. Take deep breaths. You tell stories about this guy. You know, he killed a lot of people. You know how guys like him kill people? The planet for weeks now has come up from behind.
Fighting face to face, that's a different story.
I heard once he got in a bar fight with the entire Japanese Olympic judo team. He took out four of them before the rest of them ran.
Which year? Because 64 to 72 are pussies. They didn't even medal.
Need to look out your living room window for a few minutes.
Time?
Minus 22.
What time is it?
It's 9:15.
Capitals are in LA. Start soon.
Follow the NHL?
I like football.
She's in. Third floor, 3 East. At the corner.
Corner! I don't think you understand how unpopular you are. I could deliver you in 100 pieces. They give me a separate medal for each one.
To the Bellway, to the drop site.
No, we blew our whole window on the chase. We won't make it.
So? Parkway to the Bellway. He dies in 50-50. We missed the handoff anyway.
No, the mission comes first.
I can help you. I can make you rich.
Shut up.
You go in a John Doe. You do not go back to Boston. Assume they're on. All right? You gotta walk from here. You were trained to surmount any obstacle. Go.
Back is clear.
Time.
-7.
There's another way, please. Listen to me. We cannot sit down.
Shut up!
So punctual in this business.
Counterintelligence is the place you want to be right now, Stan. I mean, what's it take to rob a bank? Stick a couple fingers in your pockets and give me all your money? In CI, we're up against the most sophisticated enemy in the world.
I'll tell you one good thing about bank robbers, they speak English. They got me in beginning Russian 4 days a week.
Ugh. You got an ear for languages?
I had a very attractive French teacher 1 year in high school. I got a B+.
Oh, coffee.
Oh, just what I need.
We getting started soon there, boss?
Timmy Chef isn't here. He's 20 minutes late.
He had a little too much vodka last night.
I've been working with him since he defected. He hasn't been 20 seconds late for anything.
Oh, where is he coming in from?
I don't know. He only deals with the director and the AG. I don't even know where he stayed last night.
Mormon. Since Reagan got elected, he starts his meeting at 7 a.m.
Reagan's not a Mormon.
Fundamentalist, whatever. The goal's the same, to wear down the enemy by waking up earlier than they do.
Who's Timoshev?
He's this ex-KGB colonel. Blew the whistle on these Directorate S undercover agents supposedly hiding all over the U.S. Super secret identities, no one has any idea who they are.
Well, you don't buy it?
There's not a single piece of evidence. Look, you get these guys like Timoshev, right? They come over, they get these huge resettlement packages. We're talking millions of dollars. So they say things to us to justify it. They make up stories to make us happy. Super secret spies living next door, they look like us. They speak better English than we do.
According to Timoshev, they're not allowed to say a single word in Russian once they get here. I mean, come on. Someone's been reading too many spy novels. Talking figment of the imagination. You understand? You make any noise, I will kill you immediately.
FBI paid me $3 million when I came off. And more since as a consultant, you can get twice that. $3 million as the most valued of defectors. Directorate as officer. Another three for returning me. Just go to the FBI.
Car won't start. We're gonna have to take the bus to the metro.
Oh, Dad.
Yeah?
Mary got 2 goals and an assist last night versus LA.
Did they win?
No, it was a tie.
I'm not going in today, so you're gonna have to handle Portland Rotary and call Swiss Air.
You know how much they paid that asshole? $3 million.
Henry was looking for a skateboard. It's not in the garage, is it?
No.
Let's go, Henry.
Huh? Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
What, no coffee for you?
No, thanks.
We have to get rid of him tonight.
I just coded the message. I'll drop it on the way to work. You don't have to stay here. He's secure in there.
There were witnesses. If they figure it out, I mean, they could be looking for him in a couple of hours. I'm gonna stay.
Yeah, told you. Should have built that secret underground chamber in the basement.
You mean the wine cellar you wanted to put in under the laundry room?
I did say it could have other uses.
Anyway, $3 million?
He can buy himself a diamond-plated coffin.
Female witness. She saw a guy knock the victim down, grab the purse, and run this way.
Give me that description one more time, please.
Somebody come this way.
All right, if you do have a victim, have him respond to this location, north end of DuPont Circle. All right. Did you notify Parks? Central? Absolutely. I'll notify Parks.
We here?
Captain, I did not know you're back.
You two are working late.
She has great promise. We're putting in extra work.
Leave us, I will teach her how we do it in the field.
Now, my dear. Begin.
I I am sorry, Captain.
I'm sorry. Use the contraction.
I'm sorry.
No. Bastard.
Watch.
Don't overcommit.
Remember me, Captain? How's the gang?
Jughead is in serious trouble.
Okay, we'll do some reading and some stirring for me, okay? Paige, what are you working on?
Social studies, paper on how the Russians cheat on arms control.
Hmm. That's, Hendrickson, right?
Yep.
Yeah. I don't know how you can look at him all day with that hair lip.
Mom, that's his handicap.
So, what's the trouble with these guys?
Well, Betty and Veronica were hosting a charity drive.
Yeah.
But so
I'm home.
Oh, Dad.
Yeah.
We launched our rocket today in science.
Wow, is it manned or unmanned?
Unmanned, but tomorrow we're gonna give Commander Stafford a plaque to commemorate the mission.
Well, I'm sure he'll be very honored. Go look out the window. Yeah. I made the drop in the park, no response.
Maybe he can move in with us permanently. I can fix up a spare bedroom for him.
I have a meeting later, we'll know more then.
Holy shit! Car ever.
Henry, language.
Don't fall in love with it. It's only a rental until the Oldsmobile gets fixed.
I said that word once and you guys grounded me for a week.
Whenever you're ready.
Here we go. Dad's gonna start this up right here, right
Ice
now.
Ice cream Olympics. Take your time. Eyes on the cone.
B.com.
Eyes on the cone. Don't faint too early. Don't faint too early. Know your distance. Know your distance. Oh no! All right, Henry, you're up.
War paint. Here we go.
War paint. Let me see your war face.
Like it.
Eyes on the cone. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Ease up. Remember the training. Oh, the big nose cone! Mom, you're up.
No, thanks.
Come on. Just
okay.
Just
little one. No, thanks.
Little one? Come on, let's see. Oh. Sorry.
Stop.
Maybe we can have a checkers round robin when we get home?
I'm just dropping you guys off. I gotta meet a client.
Why are you meeting a client so late?
He's coming in on a late flight, wants to grab a drink. You know, that's what business is all about, honey. Anyone can make travel arrangements, but you keep the executives happy, you keep the accounts. How have you been, Martha?
Fine, Clark. Please come in.
So, referencing our meeting this evening, obviously you understand it's been classified top secret by the Internal Affairs Division of the Committee to Oversee United States Counterintelligence Agencies. Do you swear to tell the truth, whole truth, et cetera, et cetera?
I do.
Great. So, big day at FBI counterintelligence.
Yes, it was.
Obviously, we know most of it, but I just want to hear the details from you because a crisis can provide an opportunity to uncover the leaks that we have been looking for in your office. So just tell me what you saw. Thank you.
Well, I know that a man was kidnapped. He was supposed to speak at a conference this morning, but he didn't show.
Mm-hmm. And did there appear to be a centralized response to the kidnapping?
They were in the secure vault all day.
Did you get a look inside this time?
They don't let me in there. And you know that.
I know, I'm sorry. Please go on.
Well, the man that they kidnapped was Russian. He was someone very important in the KGB, I think.
Right.
By early afternoon, they had tied it to a police report in Northeast DC about a man who was kidnapped last night. And they have a vehicle description. 77 Oldsmobile, gold with DC plates and bumper stickers.
And descriptions of the kidnappers?
Two men and a woman. One of the men, average height with dark hair.
And what specific actions did Agent Bartholomew order?
Extra agents were sent to surveil the Soviet embassy. Agents went out to all the ports and train stations. They thought the Russians would take the man out of the country.
How would you best describe Agent Bartholomew's mood?
Angry? But I don't want to get him in trouble.
No, not at all. Our counterintelligence units, they safeguard the security of our nation, Martha. So we have to safeguard their security.
The Reagan administration revealed today that after a month long review, we'll honor the agreement with Iran that led to the release of the 52 American hostages.
So, House committees began a series of hearings. FBI have the car description with the DC plates. They haven't connected to a stabbing victim at Arlington Methodist yet, but I don't think it'll be long. They're all over our guys at the embassy who must have made the surveillance, which is why they can't get out to pick up my message or respond. So I think we have to assume with the feds all over them like that, they're on full operational stand down.
We should just take care of them ourselves.
What's the rush?
On an operational stand down, we're authorized to make our own decisions.
Yes, but why do you want to kill him so badly?
I want him out of my house. He's putting us all in danger, and they're just going to kill him back in Moscow anyway.
I think we should at least try and finish the mission the way it was assigned.
Oh, now you want to complete the mission the way it was assigned? I mean, you should have thought of that before, Philip. He shouldn't even be here.
Well, if you're that worried about it, maybe we could just defect ourselves. At least we'd be millionaires, Wouldn't have to worry about going to jail and leaving the kids all alone. A lot of our problems just go away. Poof.
It's very funny.
Well, let's see what we hear tomorrow.
You sure you don't want to come? Haven't even seen the new mall yet.
It's a mall.
See you, Ma.
Yeah, I know, but this one has fountains and skylights.
Bye, Mom.
When we went to dinner last week, wasn't she wearing a sweater with a bunny rabbit on it? Oh, my God.
Really?
Just call your parents, babe. Tell them you're sleeping at Lisa's house.
Do you think I'm gonna get in trouble?
Daniela?
Like that. You look nice, darling. You want to come with me and Dee to shop for makeup after you pay for those?
Errol, she's 13.
13? I don't know, Daddy. She sure looks ready to me. So long, honey. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Come
on. You're getting older, so...
I know.
It's no use fighting guys like that.
Oh, God, I wouldn't want you to.
Be a cowboy to wear cowboy boots.
Jaden says you do. No one wears cowboy boots anymore, Dad.
No, Dad. She does have a point there.
I met the new neighbors. We're gonna go over later to say hello. What, you think I killed him?
Just checking.
Stop.
You're my wife.
Is that right?
Oh, hi, you came.
Just for a second to bring over brownies and welcome you to the neighborhood.
Well, come in.
Can I offer you guys a drink or...
No.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
God, this place is a mess.
Please, don't do anything. We just wanted to bring over the brownies.
Yes, I'm so sorry.
We can come over and help. Actually, Henry can come over all day tomorrow if you want.
Oh, thank you. This is my son, Matthew.
Hi.
Do you know where your father is?
Oh, he's upstairs.
Well, do we have visitors already?
Yeah, this is Stan.
Hey.
Phil Jennings.
How you doing? Stan Beeman.
My wife, Elizabeth Page. Henry.
Hi.
Hey, Henry.
Hello.
Ooh, are those brownies?
Homemade.
Matt? Your mom's a good cook?
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
I should have taken
them. Thank you.
Oh, that's a good brownie, huh?
Yeah.
So this is a pretty good neighborhood we moved into, huh?
Wouldn't live anywhere else. You know, safe, clean, commute to D.C. is not too bad. Do you work in the city?
I do.
What do you do, Stan?
I'm an FBI agent.
FBI? Wow, what do you catch, bank robbers and stuff?
Actually, I work in counterintelligence now.
That's against spies, right?
Exactly.
Ooh. Have to make sure I don't do any spying around here.
Oh, you better not. Especially for those Russians.
Oh, yeah, they're the worst, right?
Oh, they certainly are, Philip. They certainly are.
It's probably a coincidence. FBI agents have to live somewhere.
Or they're onto us.
And this is what?
The end game. They're trying to make us do something stupid.
Either way, we get rid of Timoshev tonight. I almost did it myself this morning, but I thought you'd be pissed.
If they are watching us, the last thing you want to do is kill Timoshev. That's life in prison. That's no deals, nothing.
We take those risks every day, Philip. That's what we do.
Maybe there's another way. Look, maybe this is an opportunity. Maybe this is the perfect time for us just to think about living the life we've been living, but just really living it. Just being us.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying we might be blown. And I'm saying if they are watching us, we can't kill Timoshev. I'm also saying we are Philip and Elizabeth Jennings. We have been for a very long time. So why don't we get ahead of this, and why don't we make the first move and offer ourselves to them? We could get a lot of money, $3 million for Timoshev, $3 million for us. We just get relocated, take the good life, and be happy.
Are you joking? Is this a joke?
No.
You want to betray our country?
Well, after everything we've done, I don't think it's such a betrayal.
Defecting to America?
America's not so bad. We've been here a long time. What's so bad about it, you know? The electricity works all the time. Food's pretty great. Closet space.
Is that what you care about?
No, I care about everything.
Not the motherland.
I do, but our family comes first.
So, Paige and Henry,
we'd have a great life for them because we would have money.
What would you tell them, Philip?
The truth.
You swore, we swore, we would never tell them. That to let them grow up and live their own lives, they're not to be a part of this.
If they're not to be a part of this, they will be American, and you can't stand that. I see it every day.
I'm not finished with them yet. They don't have to be regular Americans. They can be socialists.
They're not going
to
be socialists. This place doesn't turn out socialists.
To know that it was all a lie, they would never speak to us again, Philip. And what are we even talking about? There would be no future for any of us. They would kill us all.
They'd never find us. They would never find us.
Have you looked at our trunk?
He was a fool. He came back to give speeches. Left clues about where he was staying. We'd be more careful. Thank you. Colonel.
Come. Philip, I'd like you to meet Elizabeth. Elizabeth, this is Philip.
Pleased to meet you.
Likewise.
I leave you two to get acquainted. There is so much to talk about. Your lives up until now. Philip and Elizabeth's lives, not the other ones. Those should never be discussed. It would be easy to believe in the Elizabeth who grew up in Chicago, Illinois, Philip, if you don't know any other story. Elizabeth, you'll be less likely to make a slip one day if there is no other version of this man you're hiding away in the back of your mind. Please, sit.
Would you like some tea?
Yes, thank you.
County liaison.
How can I help you?
Sergeant Vaughn, Fairfax Sheriff Department. I'm looking for a John Doe. Would have come in Thursday night. Male, Caucasian, 5'10", knife wound to the stomach.
Let me look. Oh, I'm sorry, Sergeant. He expired that night.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, neighbor.
Hey, Stan, how's the moving coming?
Oh, you know, it's a long way to go.
You want a beer?
No, thank you, but I could actually use some jumper cables if you have them. My wife's car didn't quite make the trip from St. Louis.
Sure, come on in.
Oh, great.
You sure no beer?
Oh, I'd love to, but I gotta go into work.
You don't even get a day off to move in?
You know, we got this real shitstorm brewing. Looks like I'm gonna be working 7 day weeks for the foreseeable future. You having car trouble?
Oh, nothing major. Cracked PCV hose.
This is an Oldsmobile Delta, huh?
Yeah.
77?
Mm-hmm. I wanted the coupe, she wanted the sedan, so we settled on this with a V8.
Beautiful styling with these stacked headlights. GM can't make these fast enough, huh?
Yeah, it's a great car.
You weren't tempted by one of those Japanese upstarts, huh?
I think I'd fit in one.
Oh, yeah, I hear you on that. Oh, great. Thanks.
You bet.
Well, I gotta go back.
Of course. Not to you.
What's it called?
Piroshki.
It's like a meat dumpling. They kind of like them. I kind of like them too. They're juicy.
Hey, Jamie. This is Agent Gadd, my former deputy.
How you doing?
He's detailed to a CIA counterintelligence task force at Langley. He's going to bring them up to speed on Timoshev, and hopefully they can help us out.
Hey, Chris.
Frank.
Agent Beeman, do you think there's any chance that Timoshev is still alive?
He's been here about 10 minutes, Frank.
Well, it's my understanding he has some special insight.
Yeah, my bank robbery assignment the last 3 years, I was undercover.
Undercover? With who?
A white supremacist group out of southern Arkansas.
24 principals currently awaiting trial.
Oh, shit. You were living it the whole nine yards?
Yeah, I barely saw my family.
It's one thing we haven't had around here. Someone with that mindset.
I thought you were here for your good looks.
Timoshev, sir, when you're betrayed by one of your own...
Hey.
When you're betrayed by one of your own, you're not inclined to put him out of his misery fast. I would bet the Russians would go to considerable lengths to get him back there so they can look him in the eye. before they blow his brains out.
If you grabbed him, but you couldn't get him out of the country right away, where would you keep him?
Well, I wouldn't take him to the embassy. I wouldn't want to get near any Russians where we might be looking. I wouldn't want to be on the street as much as I could avoid it, or anywhere I didn't usually go. I would probably make a beeline to my house, tell you the truth. Surely the safest place you can be, strange as that may sound. And I would just follow my regular routine, keep him there till the heat died down.
Well, if he's at somebody's house, we're never going to find him.
No, I wouldn't think so, sir.
Thanks.
So were you, like, burning crosses and shit with those guys, or like Heil Hitler?
It was a little deeper than that.
Like what?
Hey, Dad. Can we get a racing stripe on the Oldsmobile?
I don't think your mom would like that.
Why not?
She doesn't like new things.
Please welcome a true American hero, commander of Gemini 9 and Apollo 10, astronaut Thomas P. Stafford.
Taking him to our neighbor.
You are?
Yeah. I was gonna drive him out, hand him off further from home, but you seem to have taken the distributor cab.
So you're leaving me?
I'm gonna make a deal where you don't have to talk to the Americans if you don't want to, if you think that'll make you a traitor, but you will come with me and the kids. It won't be exactly what you want, but you'll adjust.
So you're just deciding for both of us?
Yeah, one of us has to.
Why you?
Because we're running out of time. Why can't we do this together?
Because I'm a KGB officer. Don't you understand that? After all these years, I would go to jail. I would die. I would lose everything before I would betray my country. Now I'm finishing this.
Come on!
Sorry, I never meant to hurt you. They let us have it away with the cadets. It was part of the job. Hey, Perk.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about? How did you hurt her? How did he hurt you?
Do what you want with them. Take them to the Americans if that's what you want.
Oh,
It's too swollen to hide.
We're gonna have to clean the trunk later.
We made the planets.
On which planet did your class make?
We made the sun and Earth.
Sun? No, sorry, this is the sun.
Well, that was Earth with the moon, of course.
But did the commander land on it?
On the moon?
Yeah.
No, he didn't land on the moon, but he got close to it.
You know, the moon isn't everything. Just getting into space is a remarkable accomplishment.
You gotta hustle up.
Mm-hmm. Hello.
I wanna go to the moon.
Me too. That'd be awesome.
We got a 7:30 ice time. What are you doing up so early on a Sunday?
It's these crazy shifts I'm working. I've been up since 5.
Ouch.
Yeah, I might as well just skip sleeping altogether.
Right.
How you doing, Henry?
Good, how about you?
Good, thanks. Whoa, what happened to your neck?
Ugh, shaving.
2 band-aids? What are you, a butcher?
I gotta change my blades more often.
You know what you get your dad next Christmas?
What?
An electric razor.
Okay.
Have a good practice.
Take it easy.
Thanks.
Go to the drugstore?
Sure.
I like that guy, Philip.
Really? You do?
Yeah, I do. I mean, there's something a little bit off about him, maybe, but I think he's a good guy.
Something a little off?
Yeah, I don't know, maybe.
You know, I've actually been feeling that too, excuse me.
You have?
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to spend 3 years with the Gold Legion to have instincts. It's just kind of a vibe he gives off,
yeah.
Right? You know, I was actually feeling it with Bill Westerly from the condo board too. Did you get that from him?
No.
Yeah, when he was talking about the assessments, I was like, this guy is running drugs in this place. And the mailman, I just have kind of an instinct, is a pimp.
Okay.
Or something. You could never really.
Yeah, you made your point.
Sure. Honey. You're back in the regular world, okay? So you need to stop those alarm bells going off every 10 minutes. You're officially now surrounded here by the most normal, boring people in the world. So enjoy it.
Okay, I will enjoy it.
Okay.
Back. I'll stick that in your heart.
General Zhukov.
Where is the traitor?
He tried to escape. We killed him.
You missed the handoff. Your comrade died. Now the traitor is dead instead of in our hands. The center is worried enough to send me here to see you.
General,
please sit, Elizabeth.
Thank you.
The American people have elected a madman as their president. He's expanding their military forces on a massive scale. He's against nuclear arms control agreements. He makes no secret of his desire to destroy us. Our war is not so cold anymore, Elizabeth. What happens behind enemy lines will determine the outcome of this struggle. You reported several times over the years about Philip. Can we trust him?
Yes, I was wrong. It was nothing, a little... a phase in a person's life.
So he's not responsible for the mess this mission has become?
I was the one at fault, General. I am very sorry.
Don't let that happen again, Elizabeth. I may not be able to protect you if you need me. These times bring out the worst in our people. I'm fighting now against comrades in our own organization who are starting to act like they did in our darkest days.
I understand.
If I'm not here, you are to fight on. Our enemy is strong and capable. We must meet the challenge. The orders are going to change now. The risks are going to be greater. Your comrade who died was a hero. We are going to need more of those now.
We won't let you down, General.
You were just a child.
Is there anything new in here?
The Virginia State Police report.
Anything on the weapon?
Not yet.
Our deceased John Doe from Arlington Methodist is proving very difficult to track down. Either he's a KGB Directorate S officer who got killed while kidnapping Timashev, or he's a drifter who got stabbed in a fight in Arlington. His picture's out to every police department in the country, but it's a needle in a
haystack. Say haystack.
Mr. Deputy Attorney General.
The Attorney General and I have just come from the White House. President Reagan is outraged that the KGB thinks it can kidnap someone with impunity on American soil. The President has signed Top Secret Executive Order 2579, authorizing the Federal Bureau of Investigation and Counterintelligence Office to take all necessary measures to neutralize Soviet Directorate S sleeper cell agents in the continental United States. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to war. It is a war that will be fought quietly by the men and the women in this room. It will not be short. And it will not be easy, but we have truth and justice on our side, and we will prevail.
Why didn't you tell me about Timashev?
We aren't supposed to talk about our other lives.
It wasn't really your other life. It happened in training.
It was a long time ago. Put it behind me. Things are about to change, Philip. It's gonna get uglier. More dangerous.
We'll be fine. Don't forget, we've been doing this a long time.
I was born in Smolensk. My father died fighting the Nazis at Stalingrad when I was two. There was a picture of him in his uniform. He was pale with bushy eyebrows. He was smiling. Although, of course, he was going off to die. My mother was a bookkeeper for the local party committee. My name was Nadezhda.
Thank you.
My God, climate.
Yeah. It's an air conditioner.
Is it cold air?
Yeah.
Oh my God. I'm not ready.
No, we're supposed to be married now. That's all. They'll expect us to have children eventually. Or I don't know, maybe you just don't find me attractive.
What do you think so far?
You know, they tell you everything, but I don't know, when you see it, it just seems brighter.
There's a weakness in the people. I can feel it.